group of strangers has agreed to be abandoned in the Fijian Islands. They come from different backgrounds.
I was born 3 months early with mild cerebral palsy. The doctor said, yeah, he's not going to walk. He's going to be in a wheelchair.
Cultures.
Growing up in Nigeria was like survivor. You know, it was like survival of the fittest.
And experiences.
I played Division I lacrosse. I was in a moped accident that caused me to lose my left leg above the knee. And then I became a Paralympian. And I hold the United States record for the 100 meter.
But despite their differences, they must rely on each other in order to survive.
My biggest asset as a teacher is being able to connect. I always hear people get on the show and they say, I'm not here to make any friends. And I'm like, well, I am. Be my friend. Let's have an authentic and genuine connection and bond. That way, when I get to the end, you can vote me the million, and then we can go out for pizza and coffee afterwards.
Being 19 and as young as I am way more than just my age. I'm actually attending Brigham Young University right now, so I'm like a student, pet cremator, business owner, hybrid. I'm all these things. Like, look at me. I think I'm just a fun and energetic, I don't know if that's a word, energetic person, and I don't think I cater to one specific group. I can cater to anybody.
I am unapologetically Survivor's biggest fan. I mean, I've loved Survivor longer than I've known my husband, my kids, my nursing career. I've spent the last 22 years imagining this moment. It's finally here. I get one shot at it. What am I gonna do with it?
Growing up in a tough environment, I'm a very adaptable and a very resilient person. That's how I've gotten to where I am today in life. When I've been tired, when I've been beaten down, when I've been told no, that's my time to shine and kick ass.
I'm gonna play the game as hard and as fast as I can, just like I do my life. Just like the way I surf, just like the way I go out on a weekend. And I'll be honest with you, I've already spent part of it, so I really need $1 million.
They'll form a new society where they decide the rules of how this $1 million game is played.
I'm not gonna sit around and wait for other people to determine my game. I make my fate, I make my game.
It's up to them who stays and who goes.
One thing I do as a psychologist is get people to do things that they don't want to do. They'll figure it out once their torch is getting snuffed.
Each player must learn to adapt to their new society or they'll be voted out.
I want the game to be chaotic. I want no one to know what's going on. For me, that's my comfort zone.
In the end, only one will remain to claim the $1 million prize.
I want this so bad. I used to daydream about seeing my name up in the opening credits.
I'm buckled up and I'm ready for the ride.
Let's do this.
Who will have what it takes to outwit, outplay, and outlast all the rest? This is Survivor 43.